answers prayer. What's your petition? What you going to ask for tonight? And God said, what do you have need of?
Hallelujah.
Ask anything.
Praise your name, Jesus. I love you, Lord.
That's a lot to meditate on, isn't it?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
It's not a genie in a bottle that we can just wish this to happen, but I promise you, if he comes to you and say, ask, and I'm going to give it to you. If we pray according to his word and his will, there's no limitations to what God will do to them that ask. The enemy's coming in on every side. Worldliness, compromise, apostasy. Amen. Mother against mother-in-law. Daughter against daughter-in-law. Children against parents. Parents against children. Trouble on, but the word of God said it would be like this. Word of God said these days were coming. Word of God said we live in perilous times. But what can we do when the enemy comes in? I want to be like Judah and Jehoshaphat. When they stood before the Lord with their little ones and their wives and their children. And the Bible says that Judah gathered themselves. What did they do? It says to ask help of the Lord. Woo! Oh yeah! We've been a great nation. We have multiplied like the sand of the sea and the stars of the sky. But it don't matter how big our number is. If we don't have God to help us, we're going to lose the battle. Church of God, from the devil in the decade in the 80s. Yeah, we're the biggest Pentecostal organization under the face of the sun. But my friend, are we doing everything God would have us to do? If the devil comes in, who's going to help us? It isn't going to be number. It's going to be somebody that says, Lord, I need your help today. And out of every city of Judah, they come to seek the Lord. I don't know who you're going to ask help for, but I believe I've got a helper that will help us more than anyone else or anybody else. His name is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. He will help his church and help his people. I don't know how much more I can go. Well, just come and let's gather together and ask help of God. Bible says as they was asking and helping, asking help from God, that all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
The children of Moab and Mount Seir are going to come down and kill us. We have not the ability to withstand the onslaught. We need your help. Bible says the Spirit of God moved upon Jehaziel.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And gave them a word of comfort and a word of the Lord. I'm here to tell you, when you have a word of comfort and you have a word from heaven, it doesn't matter what happens all around you.
Thank you, Lord.
It don't matter if your boat's broke in two and everything's falling off. Hey, an angel stood by me tonight and said, we're not going to die. Paul told them on the ship, hey, God said we're not going to die. Fear not for your lives. And you know what he said? I believe God. Hey, well, we got to go overboard. We got to get onto our life support boats. No, you better stay on board because God said we're not going to die. And I believe God. You may trust that little boat. You may want to try to make it to the shore in your own power, but I believe I'll stay on this sinking boat when God says I'm not going to die. Well, when you get a word from heaven, you hear me now, church, it don't matter what your surroundings look like and what the circumstance is. When God said it, my friend, you can stay right where you are. And it says, my God knows a whole lot better. And I know, and my God's going to supply, and my God's going to answer, and he will make it work to his glory.
Woo!
Amen. The Spirit of God moved upon him and says, fear not, be not afraid nor dismayed by the reason of this great multitude, for the battle's not yours,
hallelujah,
but God's. A lot of times we try to work this thing out with our fleshly words and our fleshly ways and try to get in the middle of the battle. But if we'd be like Jehoshaphat and the children of Judah and come ask God for help, let him fight the battle. Let him work it out. Let him take control. I promise you, he's a whole lot bigger and can do a whole lot greater and better than the arm of the flesh can do. But my friend, let's ask God again to help us and to heal us and to touch our family and send Holy Ghost revival. It's not our battle. We are instruments. We try to be mouthpiece and say the right words. But when we've done all and said all, it's time to ask God to help and stand and see the salvation of the Lord. For you shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourself, stand you still, and see the salvation of the Lord. Oh, God's with us. Let's just grab the Ark of the Covenant. It don't matter how we're living, what we're doing. When the Ark's there, we will win. That's what Hophni and Phinehas thought. And when they got the Ark, the Philistines still whooped them. Because Hophni and Phinehas wasn't living right. Eli wasn't rebuking them like he should have. And just because we say we're in the church and we've got art don't make everything right. But when we have done what's right and we have been cleansed and washed in the blood, we present ourselves before God, I promise you, then we can stand still and say, you know what, I'm covered, I'm protected, I'm washed in the blood, I've got a wall of fire, I've got a wall of faith, I've got a wall of blood, and nothing shall my enemies harm me. Though the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall raise up a standard against that devil. He can't touch us, he can't harm us, he can't take us, because we're God's property and we're God's child, and it's his fight and not ours. Why don't you quit worrying and fretting and start asking God for help and watch God win the battle? Holy Ghost is being good to our souls. Stand you still, see the salvation of the Lord with you. O Judah and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed, for tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Jehoshaphat bowed his face to the ground. The hall of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell. Came into God before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. I'm here to tell you, when's the last time we've had a comforting word of the Holy Ghost to say, get off your face and stand up and realize that I'm still God and I still have everything under control. All you've got to do is bring your petition and ask, and I will meet your need and touch your life. There's power in unity, asking together. You hear what I'm saying? Amen to God. How many folks have we got confidence in to call and pray? Said, hey, help me pray right now. And you know they're going to stop what they're doing, turn everything off, and say, God, we got a need right now. We're in church. We're hurting. We're bleeding. People are dying and going to hell. And the church has all power in heaven and in earth. We have the keys to lock and to unlock. You hear what I'm saying? The church is not powerless. It is the most powerful organization on the face of the planet earth. Amen. The Catholic Church may be the richest, but they're not the most powerful. Amen to God. They may have their gold and may have everything piled up there in the Vatican in Rome, but I'm here to tell you, Peter and John said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, woo, I give unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen to God. Pick up yourself and walk. And immediately he felt strength in his ankle bones. Peter and John weren't powerless, but they knew who they served. And they knew who was their king and who was their God and who was their healer. His name was Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. We have power in unity.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The longer you go to church with folks, the more you know about them.
Right. Thank Help him, Lord.
And we can allow it to let it do one or two things. We can allow the devil to drive wedges and nitpick and pick each other apart. Or we can use that long-term relationship to realize we're all human. We're all fighting hell. And we need each other's help. You hear what I'm saying? We ain't got time to put no one down. We ain't got time to beat no one up. Because we're fighting the same devil. And you may be the one down. And next weekend you may be the one that need to be picked up. You may need somebody you bit on, you chewed on, to come over and throw his arm around you. And said, you know what? We're working this thing out together. And we're going to make it. Just keep on keeping on. Amen to God. We're going to make it together because we're binding together. And when we are unified, we cannot fall. Woo! Listen to this. Matthew 18 through 20. Verily I say unto you, whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Do we really believe that? I bind that devil that's on my child in Jesus' name. I bind that devil of deception. I bind that spirit of homosexuality, that spirit of lust, that spirit of hatred, that spirit of alcohol, that spirit, amen, of nicotine. That spirit of iniquity, that lawlessness, I bind it in Jesus' name. Do you realize how much power we have in prayer? We're just not speaking words to the wind. Woo! But I believe that God's people can realize what we bind on earth is bound in heaven. Oh, yeah, you know why? Because you're the Holy Ghost. Comes down and wraps himself around that old spirit and puts his grid of bondage on that devil and looses our family, looses our church, and looses, amen, to God, their soul. Because Jesus overcome the devil, we can overcome the devil. And greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. And whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven. Because heaven has the power and the ability to bind. We're just bringing heaven down to where we're at through our prayers and through the blood of Christ, and the devil is a defeated foe, and he's bound. Instead of us being bound, he needs to be bound. Instead of us getting defeated, he's defeated. Instead of us, amen to God, coming down to press and sick and afflicted, it's time for the church to afflict the devil. Huh? Oh, we don't believe that no more. Whatsoever you loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. We lose healing, Holy Ghost. We, oh, you preaching that, claiming it. No, that's Bible right there, friend. Amen. We lose, oh Lord, all the power of God to move in our lives. Heaven shut up. We're losing it. By faith in your prayer and praying according to God's word and God's promise and God's plan, and watch God touch your life. Sometimes I go to prayer and I feel like I'm not a getting nowhere, and then I begin to bind hell instead of hell bind me. You hear what I'm saying? And then I begin to say, Lord, I need to have that Holy Ghost free again and let him flow in my own. Woo! And before long, amen, as I pray his word, I say, well, you say whatever I bind on earth is bound in heaven, and whatever I loose on earth is loose in heaven. And then before you know it, amen to God, amen, my mind clears up and heaven opens up and